Now we have again related with the complex number, because this video is especially on operation of complex number. In operation especially we do like addition, subtraction and multiplication and division, because mainly there are four operation in general mathematics. So here we start the operation on the complex number, like previous video, that is on the imaginary quantities, but in this video we include operation of complex number. First here we start with the algorithm, because basically we know that you do the with the examples, then first you know in your mind what are the algorithm behind it. Okay, so first here we introduce the concept, like on the addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Okay, so there are four basic operation, and now here we write down the algorithm with the arbitrary or the general form, and then after that we take the examples related to the operations like addition, multiplication and division. So now here we start. We know that the definition of the complex number, if A and B are the real numbers, because everyone, I think in previous video also show out the definition, but especially for the operation again I introduce the definition for the complex number. If A and B are the real numbers, then a number of, in the form of like Z equal to A plus IB, where A and B are the real numbers and I is here imaginary. Therefore, a complete form of the number is like Z equal to A plus IB. This is a complex number. And now, operation on complex number. First here we introduce addition of complex number. Addition of complex number, here we, because in general form here we have Z equal to A plus IB. So now here we have two complex numbers, Z1, that is A1 plus I1B. And now Z2 equal to A2 plus IB2. Okay, so there are two complex number, and now we add here Z1 plus Z2. Okay, and then we write the value for Z1 like A1 plus IB1 and now plus A2 plus IB2. Okay, in this case, you have any type of complex number. First, you separate out like terms. Like term, it means here you have A1 and A2. They both the terms, they are without I. So first you separate out. Okay, and write down in the form like you have both signs here plus, so you write down in the plus form here. And like IB1 and IB2, again you separate out, you write down here, because both term having I and I, so I is common, so I is outside. And now you have the result is A1 plus A2 and now plus I B1 plus B2. Okay, suppose in case of you have the three complex number, and now you find out the addition. The same example we have here, like Z1 equal to A1 plus IB1, Z2 equal to A2 plus IB2 and Z3 equal to A3 plus IB3. Okay, similarly we add again. Now we put with three bracket with the addition sign. And now the concept is same. Again you separate out the like terms. A1, A2 and A3. These like terms you put in the bracket. And other like terms like with I with B1, I with B2 and I with B3, you write down separately here. And now these three terms, I think you have here like I is iota and iota is a common. And then inside value like B1 plus B2 plus B3. So this is the complete solutions. So it is very easy going if you add the two complex number. Only you separate out the like terms and then you got your result. Okay, because addition is very easy going in the complex number. But the subtraction is again the same thing. There is no change in the subtraction, because addition and subtraction both are the same part. But one thing is different there, only you have the negative sign here. Like again we consider here Z1 and Z2, and Z1 we know that A1 plus IB1 and Z2 equal to I, A2 plus IB2. Okay, now here we find out the difference between these two. So Z1 minus Z2, so you write on the first bracket, minus of the second bracket. Okay, one thing now in addition there is no change, because plus sign, that is plus plus always plus. And so there is no change inside a number, but minus sign change their nature. So first here minus you multiply A2, then your number minus again minus A2 here, and minus plus again minus. So both term are now negative here. But the concept is same in addition and subtraction, you separate out like term. So we have here A1 and A2, these are the like terms, so you write down in the form of like minus here. And now IB1 and IB2, you write down again separately here. But one major concept is what? I is common. So you put right down I is outside and B1 minus B2. So this is the complete solution. So there is no change between addition and subtraction, because the one major difference between there is sign only, minus sign, because minus sign change the nature of the inside numbers. So only in separation you remember minus sign is very important there. Okay, but in the third operation like multiplication of the complex number, that is very easy going. You have z1 equal to a1 plus ib1 and z2 equal to a2 plus ib2. Okay, so same concept you apply here, z1 multiplied by z2. So you write on first bracket into the second bracket. Okay, and we know that the concept of multiplication. If first bracket multiply on the second bracket, then you take the first element of the first bracket with whole second bracket. Like here you have a1 with whole bracket of this. So you write down here a1 and then whole bracket, ib1 and then whole bracket again we have here. Okay, so a1 is multiple of this value and ib1 multiple of this value. So your bracket is common. But now you simplify the value, like a1 multiply by a2, so a1 a2 and a1 multiply by ib2, so you write down here I a1 b2. Similarly, ib1 multiply by a2, so ib1 a2 here, and then ib1 and ib2, because I is repeated here, so I into I is I square, and now b1 b2 you put as it is. Because here we have the arbitrary number, therefore we have the confusion. If you have the numeric value like 2 and 4, so 2, 4 is 8, directly you write out. Okay, and now we know that in the previous video also, I square is minus 1, because we know that I equal to under root minus 1 and x prime on both the sides, then I square equal to minus 1. So we put I square equal to minus 1, so here we have I square. So in place of I square we put minus sign here. So okay, so you replace this I square with the minus sign, and now in both the terms like I and I, so I is outside, a1 a2 and then I with this term, and now this minus sign, so this now comes into the real form. So a1 a2 and b1 b2, both these two terms are now real, so you separate out here and then with the iota I write down here. So this is a complete simplified form. So there is no two typical operations in which you operate suppose some arbitrary numbers, that is maybe lengthy going, but you take the with the numeric value. In numeric value also that is very easy going, because you directly got the result. But here we write down the algorithm, so algorithm process is very easy. Okay, so now we have the fourth operation. Continue with the fourth operation, division. Division of complex number. In division of complex number again we have the same z1 equal to a1 plus ib1 and z2 equal to a2 plus ib2. Okay, and then z1 divided by z2, so you put the value of z1 here like a1 plus ib1 and in place of z2 a2 plus ib2. Okay, so in this type of case, if your complex number are in form of the denominator, then one concept always you apply on the simplify your division number, like division of complex number, is rationalizing your denominator. Rationalizing your denominator means you have any type of denominator, only you here you multiply and divide with the opposite sign. Like you have here plus sign, then multiply by minus sign. Okay, so a2 plus ib2 here, so a2 minus ib2 and a2 minus ib2, because you have multiply and divide, the concept for the unity, because you have the same number in the numerator and same number in the denominator, it means you multiply by 1. Therefore, we have the same concept. Now, nothing is changed. This is the first bracket, this is the second bracket. You multiply numerator with numerator, you write down in the bracket. And similarly, you use the concept of the identity, like one term is positive, other term is negative. And now you have a plus b and a minus b. So, this is an identity. A plus b minus b, that is a square minus b square. So, use the concept of identity. We write down here a square minus ib2 square, because your second term like ib2 in both here. So, you write down ib2 of whole square. Okay. So, now concept of this multiplication, because we know from the multiplication side, first term of second bracket, second term of second bracket again. And we write down here a1 with this bracket, ib1 with this bracket, and then simplify a1, a2. A1 IB2 and IB1 A2 and I into I is I square B1 B2. Okay, so we know that I square is minus 1. So A1 A2, and now this both the value have I, so I is outside, but minus sign also here, so you put minus sign outside, so minus plus minus inside here, and we know that again I square is minus 1, so you put in place of I square is minus 1 B1 B2. And now here we have minus minus is plus, so a2 square plus b2 square. and now we separated with the like real terms a1 a2 b1 b2 and this term with the iota, and with like your denominator now completely is without I, and so you separate out your real terms, you write down together, and iota you write down here separately, and then separate with the denominator. Now your denominator is free of iota, so you separate out. Now this is a complete complex number. You convert, you have any division of complex number, then your complex number convert into the perfect form of the complex number a plus ib. So this is a real part, this is also real part, but this is iota is given. So this is very easy going. Okay, so there are four operations here. We did like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. And now we have the examples. With the help of example, I also illustrate. Because before of this, I also explained in the algorithm. Algorithm form, it means basically we define like for all variety of the numbers, how you deal with the operations. Like in division, we do like rationalization is very important. So one by one, here we explain with the help of examples. Like first here we first operation here we have the examples like eight the following. Okay, in first question we have z1 and z2, there are two complex numbers, and now you add these two. So here we start the solution of this five questions. So first question you write down z1 plus z2 because add the following like here, and you have the separate numbers. So first you write down in form of the addition. Both the numbers they are given with the bracket, so you also put bracket, but okay, and then you separate with the bracket, there is no change. Okay, now you write down like terms, and 3 minus 4 here in one bracket, 2i plus 3i in the other bracket, 3 minus 4 is minus 1 and 2 plus 3 is 5i. Okay, so this is after addition we have minus 1 plus 5y. Similarly, second question. In second question we have z equal to 8i plus 3 and plus 5 plus 3i. Okay, so 8i plus 3 plus 5 plus 3i. Both like terms are together. But iota is there, so first you write down 3 plus 5, second you write down with iota 3 plus I, you underline the like terms, 3 plus 5 is 8 and 8 plus 3 is 11i. Okay, so 8 plus 11i you have. Third term, third question like, and we have again there are two parts, 3 plus 7 by 2i, and now here 7 plus 4 by 3i. Okay, so we separate here like 3 plus 7. So we write down here 3 plus 7. 7 by 2i plus 4 by 3i. Okay, you underline the like term. 3 plus 7 is 10. And now ii is common. So 7 by 2 plus 4 by 3. So you write down here 10 plus. Now you're taking the LCM because you have the fraction. 2 and 3, that is 6. 3 7s are 21, 2 4s are 8. So your answer is 10 plus 29 by 6i. Okay, so this is the third question. Now start fourth, in which z equal to minus 5 plus 8i, and now plus minus minus 3 and minus 4i. Okay, so you separate the like term, minus 5 and minus 3, 8i and minus 4i, again you underline the like terms, minus 5 and minus 3, minus 8, and now here 8 minus 4 is 4i. Okay, so last question is 2 of 3 plus 4i, and here 3 of 4 plus 3i. Okay, so because this is the very easy variety, this question is multiple of any scalar. So 2 3s are 6, first you simplify the bracket, 2 4s are 8i, similarly 3 4s are 12 and 3 3s are 9i. Okay, if bracket outside some number or any sign is given, then you simplify and again you separate the like terms. So 6 plus 12 and 8i plus 9i, again you underline like terms. 6 plus 12 is 18 and 8 plus 9 is 79. Okay, so 18 plus 79 is your answer. So this is very easy because here we do the addition, and now we go for the second operation with examples like subtraction and multiplication. Okay, then we have a second example for the subtraction. We have three questions for subtraction. So first, we simplify like first question. You add on first question with bracket 3 plus 4i and minus sign with another bracket minus 5 minus 3i. Okay, so first condition is what? You simplify the bracket. First bracket is open directly because here no sign, and now minus sign to change inside all sign. Like minus 5 you put and minus minus you put plus 3. Okay, the concept is same again. You separate with the like terms, you underline also, and 4i plus 3i you also underline. Okay, and then with the separation of like term also you include with sign. Like here minus 5, not only 5 you come write on together with 3. Minus 5 you write on completely because every term they are separated in form of like or unlike terms, you always write down with their sign. And now 3 minus 5 you have here, you write down minus 2, and 4 plus 3 is 7i. Okay, so now again easy because in addition and subtraction there is no change. And now second, we have 4z equal to 4 minus 11i and minus of 4 minus 3i. Okay, so 4 minus 11i you put as it is, minus 4, and now minus minus plus 3i. Again here write down the separation with like terms. 4 minus 4 minus 11i plus 3i. Okay, and again underline. So 4 minus 4 is 0 and minus sign is greater here, so you put minus sign. 11 minus 3 is 8i. Okay, so answer is minus 8i. Last question, third we have. And then minus z equal to minus 3 minus 5i minus sign of minus 8 plus 5i. Okay, so minus 3 minus 5i plus 8 minus 5i minus 3 plus 8 minus 5i minus 5i. Again you underline. Okay, and then minus 3 plus 8 is 5 and minus 5 minus 5 is 10. Okay, so that is very again easy because in addition and subtraction both are the completely the same operation, not too much difference between them. So okay, so fourth like question 3 is related with the multiplication. Okay, in multiplication here we start like z equal to, first you multiply like 2i multiply by 3 plus 4i. Okay, so you start from the very smaller side, like you have a very simple number, and then you multiply inside, so 2i multiply by 3 and 2i multiply by 4i. Okay, so 2 3 is 6i, and now 2 4 is 8i square. Since we know that I square is minus 1, so 6i plus 8 into minus 1 is 6i minus 8. It means minus 8 plus 6i is the final answer. Okay, so in multiplication is very important. Your outer side number you multiply inside, but I is in play the role very important like here. Because you multiply I with I, that is I square, and I square always being like minus 1. Okay, so now we start from the second, and now here we listed like example 1 plus I and now 1 minus I. Okay, so it is very easy going because we have 2 brackets and 2 bracket 1 plus and 1 minus sign. So using the condition like also you multiply 1 by 1 or you using the identity, like we know that A plus B and A minus B is A square minus B square. So use the concept of identity, then A 1 square minus I square, and I square we know that minus 1, so 1 minus 1 is plus 1, so answer is 2. So easy going. So we have two examples, they are related with the, one is related with the single number and another related with the identity. And now here we illustrate like third example. We have like z equal to 3 plus i multiply by 4 plus 3 r. Okay, so first number, like the same thing, first number you have with the second bracket, 3 into 4 plus 3 r, and I in the second number, again you multiply with the second bracket, 4 plus 3 r. So you have 3 4s are 12, 3 3s are 9 i, and now I into 4 is 4 i, and here 3 I into I is I square. So we know that from here I square is minus 1. So first you replace I square, you underline this part, 9 I plus 4 I is 13 I. Okay, and then plus 3, and I square is minus 1. So 12 plus 13 I and minus 3 here. So 12 minus 3 is 9 and plus 13 I. Okay, so this is the complete simplified form. If two complex number multiplied, then again you result in form of the complex number. Okay, so again one more example here we discuss, and we have of the multiplication again, like 3 plus I, and now we have 2i plus 5. Okay, so same here again, 3 plus 2i plus 5 plus I into 2i plus 5. Okay, so 3 2s are 6i, 3 5s are 15, I into I is I square, so 2i square, and now we have 5i. Since we know that I square is minus 1, so 6i plus 15, 2 into minus 1 plus 5i. Okay, so separate with the I. So first you add on this like term, 15 and minus 2 plus 6i plus 5i, 15 minus 2. Why you add on 15 minus 2? Because plus minus minus, so we have 15 minus 2. So 13, and now 6 plus 5 is 11i. Okay, so answer is very easy. Only two brackets you multiply and you got the result. So last example here we discuss. Like in this case we discuss about the three numbers. Like first bracket you have 1 plus I, second bracket you have 2 plus I, and third bracket you have 3 plus I. Okay, so maybe case 3 complex number you have multiplied. So condition is not directly you multiply these three brackets. So first you underline this two bracket. So first you simplify this two bracket and resulting value multiply with the third. Okay, so you write down with big bracket, you write down 1 with the second bracket, 2 plus I, and similarly this I with this second bracket, 2 plus I, and now bracket close and smaller bracket with 3 plus I, you do separate. Okay, so multiplication or simplification is very easy. 1 into 2 is 2, 1 into I is I into 2 is 2i, and again here we have I into I is I square. Okay, so write down 3 plus I, not worried, because this is very easy going, because operations are very easy. You underline the like terms, I plus 2i. Similarly, we have 2, and now 1 plus I, 2 plus I is 3i. And now we know that from the previous example, I square is minus 1. You put 3 plus I, so 2 minus 1 is again 1 and 3i, and then we have here 3 plus I. So you have two brackets, so multiply two brackets here, 1 into 3 plus I and 3i with 3 plus I. Okay, so multiply 1 is identity, so there is no change in bracket. 3 plus I you put as it is, 3 3s are 9 and I, and 3i into I is 3i square. So again you underline the like terms. So 1i plus 9i is 10i, and now 3i square, so in place of I square you put minus 1, 3 plus 10i and minus 3, so 3 minus 3 is 0 and plus 10i. So your resultant value is 10i. Okay, so after simplify these three brackets, you got like 10i, a single term result. So multiplication is not so much lengthy part, depend not on how many brackets are given there. Suppose 4 brackets are given there, so first you select 2 bracket in 2 bracket, first you multiply 2 by 2 bracket, and then multiply the resultant term again, you got the result. So these operations are very easy. In addition, there is no not lengthy, like only like you add 2x plus 3y and like this, only xx term you separate out and yy terms you separate out and then you add it. And the same condition in the subtraction, multiplication is same thing again. Okay, so complex number is very very easy, so not worried about the operations. Okay, now last operation here we discuss like division. Yes, then last example that is related to the divide, and divide the following complex number. Okay, so we have here complex number like 3 plus 2i, 4 plus 3i, 5 plus 3i, and 12 plus 5i. Okay, then we divide. So in division, I think you remember the algorithm for the division, in which one concept here we deliver like you have a complex number in the division form. Like in the denominator you have with the iota terms, like imaginary quantity you have in the denominator, and then always you do the rationalization. Okay, then you start like first question, you have z equal to 3 plus 2i upon 4 plus 3i. Okay, so one concept always you do here, a rationalization of denominator. Okay, then 3 plus 2i upon 4 plus 3i, then 4 minus 3i upon 4 minus 3i. Okay, again I saw the concept like how you do the rationalizations. You have the denominator pair, okay, always you change the sign between them. You have the positive sign between them, then you change with negative. You have the negative sign between them, then you convert it to the positive, and then multiply and divide the same by the numbers. Okay, so easy going now. You have multiplied the numerator with numerator, 3 plus 2i, and similarly 4 minus 3i. And here always you use the identity like a plus b and n minus b. So first number is square minus second number is square. Okay, so in case of rationalization, always you use this concept. A square minus b square, a plus b, a minus b, always multiply, then you have a square minus b square, and this concept always we use in denominator, that is a compulsory. Okay, then 3 4s are 12, 3 into this bracket 3i, and then plus 2i with 4 minus 3i. Okay, so here we have 16 and minus 9i square. So 3 4s are 12, minus 3 3s are 9, 2 4s are 8i, 2 3s are 6, and I square. Okay, so 16, and now minus 9 into minus 1. So 12, minus 9 and plus 8i, you simplify, then you have minus I, and here minus 6 with minus 1, and then at the last 16 plus 9. Okay, so you have 12 minus I, and then minus minus plus 6, and then here you have 25. Okay, so at the last 12 plus 6 is 18 minus I upon 25. You separate 18 by 25 minus 1 by 25 of I. Okay, so this is a complex number again. Now here we discuss the second question. In second question we have z equal to 5 plus 3i and 12 plus 5i. Okay, so again we do rationalization of denominator. Concept is same always, 5 plus 3i and now 12 plus 5i. So multiply 12 minus 5i upon 12 minus 5i. So multiply numerator with numerator, 3 plus i and 12 minus 5i. Okay, and again you use the condition like a plus b minus b. So 12 square minus 5i whole square. So 5, 12 are 60. Are you write down with the one time again? Here we write down separate with the bracket, because for the practice you do always in this way, and you know the multiplication, then directly you do start from the multiply here, and then write down the resultant value. Similarly, 5 twice are 60, 5 5 are 25i, 12 3s are 36i, and 3 5s are 12, oh sorry, 15i square, and then 144 minus 25, and I square, we know that is minus 1. Similarly, you put also here, and now 60 and 36 minus 25, you have plus 11i, and now minus 15 with minus 1, and then 144 plus 25, so 60 and minus minus plus 15, so plus 11i, and now 144 plus 25, that is 169, and then separate like 75 upon 169 plus 11 upon 169, you got the result. Okay, so that is very easy. Always you start from the destinations. Now we do the question number 3. Like same here, 3 minus 4i upon 6 minus 8i. Okay, so minus sign here. We have the same discuss about the numbers, like 3 minus 4i upon 6 minus 8i. So now minus sign is here, so you multiply by plus 6 plus 8i, and now again you do 6 plus 8i. Okay, so you start here like 3 times of 6 plus 8i and minus 4i multiplied by 6 plus 8i, and again use the identity a plus b minus b, a minus b, a plus b is a square minus b square, so 6 square minus 8i square, and then 3 6 are 18. Okay, and now 3 8s are 24i. Similarly, 24i here, and now 4 8s are 32i square, and then 6 6 are 36, and 8 8 are 64i square. Okay, so 18 and now 24, 24 is cancelled out, and now you have minus 32 and minus 1 here, and then 36 of 64 of minus 1, so we have 18 plus 32 upon 36 plus 64. 18 plus 32 is 50, and now here upon 100. Okay, so resultant value is 1 by 2, you cancel out. Okay, at the last we have the result that is purely real, it is without I. So maybe possible in the rationalization, in case of rationalization, because we have the very simple calculation, and now here we multiply, we got the final result as a 1 by 2. Okay, so variety of the question is different. So last example, fourth, because this example related with the square root sign, root 2 plus 3i upon root 3 minus root 2i. Okay, so concept is not same. If square root term, so concept is same again. Again you do the rationalizations. So R of D, rationalization of denominator. Okay, so under root 2 plus 3i, and then root 3 minus root 2i. So you do here root 3 plus root 2i upon root 3 plus root 2i, because minus sign here, so you multiply by plus. Similarly, we have again, you use the bracket, root 2 multiplied by root 3 plus root 2i, and similarly 3i with root 3 plus root 2i. Okay, in the denominator again use the identity a minus b, a plus b, so a square minus b square. So now here we simplify, then root 2 into root 3 is root 6, root 2 into root 2 is 2i, and now we have 3 into 3, root 3 is root 3i, and similarly 3 into root 2 is 3 root 2 and I square, and similarly here we have here 3 minus 2i square. Okay, so we know that the value of I square, root 6 you put as it is here I, but they are not like the same terms you have with square root, so you are taking I outside. You have 2 plus 3 root 3, and now here the last t root 2 with minus 1. and then denominator also you have 2 of minus 1, so you add down the like terms, 3 minus 3 root 2 plus I, 2 plus 3 root 3i, and at the last you add down 3 plus 2, okay, that is 5. So root 2, that's a real number, 3 root 2 upon 5, okay, and then 2 plus 3 root 3 upon 5i, okay, so this is nothing. You have any type of numbers, not defined, you have a square root number, you have a any numeric value, then that is not matter, only one thing is important here, you have denominator value in form of iota, in form of the imaginary quantities, then always you do the rationalizations with the denominator and then simplify with I. Because I here we simplify and then final resultant value we write down in form of the complex number. So division type of questions not compulsory, they are asking in form of the divide the following rational complex number. It may be some numbers they are in form of the division, but question is you write down or you simplified in form of a plus ib. It means you have the division in complex number, but final result you always write down in form of the complex like a plus ib, because this is the standard form of the complex number. So many different operations you apply also here, because we deliver many variety of the questions in this video, like addition, some examples with the algorithm also, subtractions, algorithm and the examples, multiplications, algorithm already we have, and then some examples we illustrate with the help of, and then finally last operation is division. First we show out the algorithm, and then finally with the help of examples I illustrate here, and then first you grasp the knowledge about the concept of iota, because here iota is very important, and now we do the practice of more questions, because the variety of the questions in the complex number is so many questions in the reference books, so many questions from your NCERT books. So first you start your first exercise and do the practice for the iota, okay, and then now next topic is conjugate of complex number. In the next video we discuss about the conjugate of complex number and properties of complex number.